please disregard the clean dishes. We had a cooking class today. It was a long day, but I had to make this video because I promised to one of my dedicated YouTube followers or subscribers, followers, doesn't matter, to bake her birthday cake. Her name is Paulette. So I called the cake Cake Paulette or Paulette's birthday cake. I'll decide when I write the recipe on my blog. And I didn't even finish updating the recipe. First time I baked it, we really, really liked it. But I think since this is a birthday cake, it needs to have more volume, so I'm adding the ingredients slightly, and while I'm doing that, I'm also writing a recipe, complete recipe, and it will be on my blog at Heghineh.com, link below this video. Yes, so I just want to congratulate Paulette on her birthday and thank her for being very thoughtful and very kind person who always comments nicely and honestly. She even put me thumbs down on my pickled watermelon tutorial because in her opinion there is no way that pickled watermelon could be something delicious. Before you do that thumbs down thing, you better try that. It's delicious. Enough about watermelon and long stories about the cake. Quickly about ingredients. First of all, I wanted to make a simple cake. So everyone that thinks of making this cake doesn't think that it's gonna be complicated, it will take time. It's gonna be simple, easy, quick, and very delicious. Ingredients, I have room temperature butter, eggs, mini chocolate chips. You don't like chocolate chips, leave it out. I have almond meal or almond flour. It just makes cake layers very soft and fluffy. I mean, not fluffy probably, but rather soft. And then I have cardamom as a spice. Very light touch of cardamom gives slightly different taste to the cake. And of course, vanilla extract, baking powder, baking soda, salt always, and flour. What else? Sour cream or yogurt, optional. Not optional, either sour cream, either yogurt. And we're gonna start by beating our butter, and I didn't mention, with sugar. So I'll beat the butter with sugar until fluffy or slightly volume in size. Slightly volume in size. Okay, slightly doubled in size, let's say, like that. And then I'll add the rest of our ingredients. So I'll start with sugar. Butter. See, I'm not very well prepared today, but eventually we'll be done with the cake very quickly, and I'll keep my promise. That's what matters. Her birthday is on September 18th, by the way. Oops. Perfect. I'll beat this and we'll go from there. Perfect. And don't forget to stop and scrape. Once or twice should be enough. And now on low speed, I'll be adding my other ingredients. Eggs, sour cream, and it's a good idea to combine dry ingredients. So I'll combine my almond meal, flour, soda powder, baking soda, baking powder, salt, I'm trying to remember, and that's it. And I'll add vanilla extract as well. Now on low mode. Teaspoonful of vanilla extract should be enough. Oh, and I'll crush my cardamom. Only three cloves, should I say. Three should be enough. Eggs one at a time. Cardamom, And dry ingredients in 2 to 3 additions should be fine. And low mode, low speed as well. And I always keep messing. I should not wear black clothes whatsoever. Okay, especially when I'm baking, but I don't really care. This looks good. Chocolate chips, I want to add and mix with spatula. You don't want to crush them, although they won't crush. It's only a small amount of chocolate chips, but it gives very nice taste to the cake. It's not chocolatey, but it's good. So we'll go here, and I want to make 3 layers. You can make it in 2 layers, but I like it with 3 layers. Birthday, to me, from childhood, birthday cakes had to be a circle shape, round shape, and have at least 3 layers. If it's not that, it's not a good birthday cake, in my opinion. Okay, I lined my baking pans, 9-inch pans, with parchment paper. And I'll split my butter into 3 portions, of course. And it's a good idea to spray the bottom of pan with some oil so the parchment doesn't move too much. Or you can simply add some of the cake butter. But what I do, let me show you, because I also want to spray the parchment paper, it peels off much better. What I do, I lightly spray it like this, and then I put it on the bottom and turn it upside down, so I have both sides oiled. Okay, let me divide my dough and then spread it evenly. Oven, 350 degrees. 20-25 minutes, or until the sides are a light golden color. Let me bake them and be back. To be very smoothly and perfectly done. Nothing will happen. It will bake and we're gonna frost it with buttercream, the simplest buttercream. I'm lucky I can put all these 3 pans at once, bake at once. So if you don't have that option, I mean, every normal oven should fit at least 2 or 3. On one, that's it. 20 to 25 minutes. Okay, and I'll go ahead and make buttercream very quickly. I bake this about 28 minutes, and don't expect them to have very gold crust. Just look on the sides, that's all that matters. Because usually when you make a cake batter with almond meal, this is the color you will see. And because the layers are quite fragile when they're very hot, let's first cool them down completely, and then we'll take it out from the pan. And be sure to pass a knife just like this before you remove them. And I'll let this cool down because I don't want to crush them. For the cake batter, the simplest, not butter, cake frosting. Let me turn up this thing. I always forget to turn up the timer. About cake frosting, it's a simple buttercream. I say probably the simplest buttercream ever. It's too hot. No, no, no.
Cream!
Yeah. Room temperature unsalted butter, and someone with his very dirty t-shirt and mouth, and simple condensed milk, of course vanilla extract. That's it, 3 ingredients. You beat the butter until fluffy and white color. Slowly add butter, caramel, not caramel, oh, condensed milk. It's been a long day. I may be mixing up some words. And vanilla extract, that's it, it's ready. Let me get some of this.
Broken, oh no.
It's not broken, I'll fix it. Yeah, mom, fix it. Yay, we fixed it. And I'm sure you noticed I have a new helper now. Someone grows up, the other one takes place. Okay, let's beat this batter carefully. And then we'll go from there. Spoonful vanilla extract should be enough. You like cardamom taste better, add one clove should be enough for the cream. And those who don't enjoy cardamom taste, for the cake use cinnamon, half a teaspoon, a little bit less than half a teaspoon, quarter of a teaspoon cinnamon, and the same amount could be used in the cream as well if you like the taste, stronger taste. I find that buttercream this way tastes much milder, so it's just an idea to flavor the cake. Also, I'm thinking, I didn't do this when I make it first time, I mean I tried it, we tried the sliced with chocolate ganache and we loved it, so I'm thinking to cover the entire cake afterwards with a thick layer of chocolate ganache, and I made some meringues. I'll cover it with meringues and the cake will be ready. That's it, this is ready. Layers are slightly warm still. You don't want to frost warm layers, you don't want to melt your buttercream. So I may even set my buttercream aside or in a fridge, although in hot weather I always put my cream in the fridge before I start frosting, but I think this is enough. We're starting to cool down here, by the way. Fall is in the air now. Very pleasant weather here in Southern California. This was about weather update. Okay, a few more minutes we can start frosting. Nice cake platter, first layer. And if you want to keep your platter very clean and neat while you're working, because you're going to be frosting the cake, simply place a couple of, you can even do with some plastic. I have parchment paper already cut. Okay, and the ganache, I'm making simple ganache, chocolate chips, semi-sweet chocolate chips. Heavy whipping cream or heavy cream will work, into microwave about a minute or so. Just keep an eye so it doesn't burn. And what else I was gonna say? Yeah, and I'll also add a little bit of butter to make the ganache more rich in taste. And there is a very small trick to keep it shiny. You wanna add some honey. At the end, after the ganache is cooled down slightly, probably a squeeze of honey will make it shiny, will make it stay shiny for a long time. And what we do is we're gonna divide our cream into three portions, equal or not very equal. It's your cake, okay, Paulette? You can make it however you like. And this time we're gonna eat it for you. So, doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be perfectly measured. First layer frost and then second, third, pour the ganache. Oh, I forgot to turn on the thing. Okay, let me frost the cake very quickly. Just like this. And then second layer. I don't know why one of the layers came out lighter color. I'll put this in the center. Almost done. You should have enough frosting to cover the top and the sides generously. If you don't like to cover the sides, leave them kind of naked. You can do it just the way you like it. And my ganache seems to be ready. 2 minutes, took me 2 minutes to melt this down. Lucinda, do you want to mix this thing?
Yeah.
You'll help me. Here you go. Mix it until it's smooth, and while it's hot, I'll add a teeny weeny bit of butter. A tablespoon or so. Just mix it until it's smooth. And I'll continue finish. And while that's cooling down, because you don't want to pour hot ganache over buttercream, it will melt it down. I'll put this in the fridge to cool down, probably 20-25 minutes. And this one will cool down as well. And that's it. Only the large ones, not the small ones. Small ones are for the cake. And Lucinda, you didn't finish your work. A little bit of honey. Okay. And this is ready. And this one looks perfect. I'm very bad at cake decorating. I may have said this a million times and I'll keep repeating. I'm not a cake person. I think to like something doing, you really need to enjoy at least eating. I'm not a very much of a dessert person. I rather on the pickled side, sour and good, delicious dishes. Spicy, flavorful. But cakes are important for birthdays. Yes. So imagine a birthday without a cake. It's a sad one. Okay, into fridge, a few minutes. Ready. You want it to cool down. As I mentioned, you don't want to melt it with ganache. And this will go on top. Oh, I wanted to add some rum on my ganache. In my ganache, a tablespoon of rum always gives very nice taste to ganaches. Right, Arnak?
Yeah.
Ganaches? Okay. And spread it out evenly or not very evenly. Don't eat those, all of them.
I'm gonna. Ones.
Yeah, the big ones, yeah, you can. Oh. Not the small ones. Just like so. I don't know how it looks on the sides. It's perfect, okay? Guys, you wanna gather? We're gonna blow the candles for Paulette.
Okay.
Huh? She's my YouTube follower and subscriber and follower. And subscriber. Someone who asked me to make birthday cake for her, and she's always very nice and kind. She comments very thoughtful comments. And she just asked, can you make a cake for my birthday? I said, yes, why not?
And this cake is cake for us too.
Yeah. Okay, and I'll put a couple of, just, you don't have to arrange them in order, big or small, a few meringues. Another idea, you can save some of the buttercream and probably pipe a few flowers if you wish. Just like this. Arnak, can you bring those pomegranates? I cleaned for Beck. You can't eat those pomegranates, those are something. I'm making something for my.
I can't eat them because they're sour.
Oh, you can? They're sweet. They're from our neighbor's tree.
Chimkara.
No?
Citrusy banana.
Oh.
But it's good.
Okay. Okay, I'll put a couple of pomegranates just to give an Armenian touch. She's Armenian on her mom's side, I believe.
Is she turning 10?
No. You don't reveal people's age, okay?
Not,
women's
there
age.
There were 10 of these. I was making a
joke. Oh, I didn't even count. Okay, I'll go get the candles. I don't know. Again, I'm not a big cake decorating person or decorator. Probably I should say, decorator?
Mm-hmm.
The way you first said it was better.
Better? Decorating thing?
Yeah.
Decorating person?
Decorator.
Okay, I can remove this. And I'll put some of the big ones on the sides. Okay, you guys have appetite for delicious cake?
No.
No?
I always have appetite for cake.
Your dad loved this cake.
He's just waiting for the video to end, take
He's
some pictures
of my camera guy, who happens to be my husband.
Who happens?
No, that's not how you say it?
No,
that's how you say it, it just sounds funny.
Okay, he's a big sweet tooth, he ate entire cake. I think Arka tried a slice, you tried a slice,
mm-hmm.
The rest he ate and he was very happy with the taste. Okay, so hopefully everyone else will like it and hopefully no one will be lazy to make it just the way I made it. Because it's very easy, simple. Okay, I'll go get the candles. This looks perfect or this
I like
looks
it.
Good?
It looks very heavy now. It's like
very heavy. Okay. Should I drizzle this with some?
No, I like it like that.
No?
That's nice.
Yeah, that's nice. Arka, Lucin, come guys, I want you to sing happy birthday and blow candles.
Happy birthday!
Yay! My youngest loves this. I mean, I'm sure all children like this. For a very sweet lady, let's say.
Who? Sandra?
No. Paulette. Her name is Paulette. Okay, I'll put this one here, okay?
Okay.
Okay, is everyone here? Arna, Pures!
Okay. 4 years old?
She's not 4 years
what
old.
What the four
come
candles?
On, come on. Lassandra, you wanna blow candles?
Sure.
Come on. But first we need to sing happy birthday to Paulette, okay? Okay, ready, steady, go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Paulette. Happy birthday to you.
Make a wish.
Yay!
And we all wish you happiest, healthiest, wealthiest birthday. That's it. Thank you so much for following and thank you all to all my followers. I appreciate and thank everyone. Did I say it right?
Yeah, that was amazing.
That was amazing.
That speech was amazing.
It was a very good speech. Okay, now we need to cut it.
Okay. I don't want cake.
You don't want cake?
More for
you
dad.
Meringue?
Yeah.
You want meringue? You want meringue?
It's like small cookies.
Who wants meringues?
Who doesn't?
Okay, let's see the inside of this cake. I tried to make it nice looking, but I don't know. It's just not my thing. Oh, look. Lili-chan, can you bring a plate? Let's try it. No, a normal human plate. Okay, I'll eat one slice for you. And guys, cakes. You want a cake, babe?
Cake.
You love this cake. Yum, 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 delicious. You want a slice? It's not a slice, it's a piece.
Yum, yum, yum.
It is delicious. It's so soft and it melts. It's delicious. It's a good recipe.
I like the chocolate chips in there.
Mm-hmm, chocolate chips. You want a piece now? It's too serious for kids. I will make a tea. This will go with tea so perfectly. What about
Gopher? You should mail her a cake, the cake.
She's in Germany.